There are several methods of exit. The most common method is the next round of funding. In case the startup raise VC funding and X plus 2X plus 3 valuation comes up. Suppose you invest at a valuation of 10 crores at a particular startup. Then next round of funding, the valuation may go up by say 100% in the VC round. Let's say by after 1 year, this goes up. So the valuation will become 20 CR. And VC, if they have put in this investment at a 20 CR valuation, they will be happy to buy your equity also, but they might offer you some discounts. They will offer you some discounted valuation. Maybe they might ask your equity at 18 crore. So you end up getting some lesser value on your investment in comparison to the current VC, but still that will be 80% of your investment. Right? If you have invested at 10 crore valuation and you are getting exit at an 18 crore valuation, you made 80% money, which is higher than any other investment asset class in the market. So that is why this is huge, but risk is also there. High risk equal to high profit opportunity, right? So another thing is you can get exit through acquisition of this particular startup. So a lot of times what happens is somebody which is making it popular as a feature of a particular startup or disrupting the leader, they are most likely to be acquired by the leader. So in case of acquisition, everybody's equity will be bought by the acquirer. Another way of exit is by selling off your equity to another investor who might have missed the opportunity in the first round or who might have came later when the opportunity is not there. So you can transfer your equity to somebody else, just like you transfer in the stock market, same way. And finally, the IPO. So if you wait for 3-4 years and the startup becomes unicorn, becomes profitable and they hit the IPO, even now companies which are into losses are doing IPO, but generally it should be a profitable status when you hit the IPO, and that moment you get an exit through selling your shares in the IPO.